गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
वी लर्न अबाउट एंडो मेम्ब्रेन सिस्टम इन द प्रीवियस क्लास एंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनेल्स इंक्लूडेड अंडर एंडो मेम्ब्रेन सिस्टम. सारा, विच आर द डिफरेंट सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स इंक्लूडेड अंडर एंडो मेम्ब्रेन सिस्टम. देविका. यस सारा.
Lysosome, vacuoles, globular apparatus.
One more. Once again, you repeat what you said. Vacuoles, lysosomes,
Golgi
apparatus, and one more. Starting with E.
Endoreticulum.
Endoreticulum or endoplasmic reticulum?
Endoplasmic reticulum.
Endoplasmic reticulum. And what did we learn about? Lysosome, we did not start, I think, no? We learned about Golgi apparatus, different functions, and about the structure of Golgi apparatus we had learned. So just summarize the points that we learned. Emeline can start. What are the points that we learned about Golgi apparatus?
They are flat, disc-like shape. They are parallelly arranged. They have two faces.
Okay. Enough. Meherin?
I was not there in the last class.
Okay. Malavika, Prabil?
Materials are packed in the form of vesicles to transport from the ER and other organelles. It also has two phases, transphase and cisphase.
Cisphase. Okay. Then Lakshmi, what else we learned?
The protein synthesized by the lysosomes, they are modified in the sterile and then only released from the transphase.
Okay, so the different products synthesized near endoplasmic reticulum undergoes modification within the Golgi apparatus. So today we are going to learn about the next organelle, that is lysosome. Lysosome also you had learned in class 9. We call them as the suicide bags of the cell. Can anybody tell me why we call this particular organelle as a suicide bags? Devi? Do you remember? No. So think about that word meaning. Meryl, why these are known as suicide bags of a cell? Suicide, you know, killing oneself. So these organelles are known as suicide bags. What could be the reason? Anybody is remembering? I had been repeatedly telling you, read the 9th standard textbook. Before joining the class, next time before joining class, you read it. I don't think anybody have read it. Valentina?
When there is a disturbance in their metabolism, they boost and their own digestive enzyme or engulf them.
Okay, that is the reason why we call them as the suicide bags. They are actually the waste disposal system of the cell. If any foreign particle enters the cell, or if there are damaged or worn out organelles within the cell, these lysosomes will engulf it or destroy it, and thereby it will help in keeping the cell clean. Other than that, when there is any disturbance in the metabolism of the cell, or when the cell is not functioning properly, these lysosomes will burst. And these lysosomes contain powerful digestive enzymes. And once it bursts, these enzymes will be released, and the enzymes released will digest the cell in which it is present. That means lysosomes will not have any existence once it kills or destroys the cell in which it is present. That is why you call it as the suicide bags of the cell. Mainly they act as waste disposal system of the cell, and they will help in keeping the cell clean. Lysosomes are membrane-bound vesicles. Vesicles meaning, I already told you, bag-like or sac-like structures. These are formed as a result of the packaging process in Golgi apparatus. So that point also I had told you in the previous class. Lysosomes are formed in the Golgi apparatus. So that can be included as one of the functions of Golgi apparatus. It helps in the formation of organelles like lysosomes. Complex sugars are formed from simple sugars in Golgi apparatus. So these lysosomes are formed in the Golgi apparatus, and these are membrane bound vesicles. As you can see in the picture, you can see the picture of a cell and the and the lysosome present inside. These are rich in all types of hydrolytic enzymes. So many powerful enzymes, or this particular organelle is filled with powerful hydrolytic enzymes. Different examples for these enzymes. You call these hydrolytic enzymes as hydrolases. So they will help in breaking down lipids, proteins, carbohydrates, etc. Carbohydrates, proteases, lipases are some of the examples for these hydrolytic enzymes. And these are active at acidic pH. That also, you know, each enzyme is having an optimum pH where they can perform or where they can carry out its activity. And these enzymes are active at acidic pH. Once again, lysosomes are membrane bound organelles. And how are they formed? They are formed as a result of the packaging processes taking place in the Golgi apparatus. And the unique feature is that they are filled with different hydrolytic enzymes or hydrolases like lipases, proteases, carbohydrates. So these enzymes can break down different particles, and they are active at acidic pH. So with the help of this particular property, or by means of having these strong digestive enzymes within it, they can act as the waste disposal system. So if there are any damaged organelles within the cell, or if any foreign particle enters, they can destroy those particles and keep the cell clean. And not only that, when there is any disturbance in the cellular metabolism, that cell as such can be destroyed with the help of these lysosomes. So in such a case, when there is a disturbance in the metabolic activities of the cell, these lysosomes can burst, and upon bursting, the enzymes present within it will be released outside and they'll be destroying the cell. So again, the function, the powerful enzymes present in lysosomes are capable of digesting the different substances like carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids. Okay, so lysosomes are membrane-bound vesicles, and these are formed from Golgi apparatus, and these structures or these organelles are filled with powerful digestive enzymes. You call these enzymes as hydrolases. Different types are there depending upon on which substance they are acting. Lipases, which will break down lipids. Proteases acts on, it will act on proteins. Then carbohydrates acting on carbohydrates, and these enzymes are active at acidic pH, and its function is, with the help of these enzymes, they can break down different particles and help in keeping the cell clean. And even if the cell metabolism is damaged, then there also lysosomes will come to rescue. So they will release the enzymes, ignoring their own existence, and these enzymes will digest the cell in which it is present. Now, next we are going to learn about vacuoles. Vacuoles are found both in plant and animal cells, but in plant cells, as you can see in the picture, they have a centrally placed large vacuole. Whereas in animal cells, the vacuoles are smaller in size. Whereas plants, they have larger vacuoles. Membrane bound. These are membrane bound structures scattered in the cytoplasm, and different substances can get stored in the vacuole. Water, sap. Sap is that fluid substance present within the vacuole. Especially this is found in plant cells. You call it a cell sap, containing different substances dissolved in it. Then excretory products and other waste materials. So vacuoles can be used for storing different substances. And the vacuole is bound by a single membrane. It is not bound by double membrane. Instead, it is having a single membrane and you call it as tonoplast. So what is tonoplast? Tonoplast is the membrane covering vacuole. Tonoplast has the ability to pump ions and other materials into the vacuole. So again, you know that materials usually will be transporting along the concentration gradient. If they have to move against the concentration gradient, requires energy, and the tonoplast has the ability to pump ions as well as other materials into the vacuole. So because of the speciality or because of the ability of the tonoplast to pump these materials inside, so inside the vacuole, different substances will get stored. So tonoplast will facilitate the storage of all these substances within the vacuole because they can pump different substances against the concentration gradient, and as a result, different ions and other substances will get stored in the vacuole. Hence, the concentration of ions in the vacuole is greater than that in the cytoplasm. So if you compare the ion concentration, the concentration of ions, different mineral ions, etc., in the cytoplasm and the vacuoles present, you will see that, or we can find that more concentration, more amount of ions will be in the vacuole than in the cytoplasm. So the reason is the ions present in the cytoplasm will be pumped into the vacuole with the help of the tonoplast. And as a result, there will be more amount or more concentration of ions within the vacuole. Once again, these are membrane bound structures, and you can find them both in plant and animal cells. In plant cells, large vacuoles are found, whereas in animal cells, small sized vacuoles are found. And usually in plant cell, there will be a large centrally placed vacuole which can push the nucleus towards one side. So usually the nucleus will be located at the center, but in plant cells, because of the presence of this, you can see it in the figure. The centrally placed vacuole will slightly shift the nucleus towards one side, and there are different functions for vacuoles. If you take the case of plant cells, they will provide rigidity, turgidity, and they also help in the storage of substances. Different substances can get stored, sugars, amino acids, so many substances, and different ions can get stored in the vacuoles. So not only useful substances, even excretory or the other waste materials also can get stored there, which will later get eliminated. And the vacuole is bound by a single membrane known as tonoplast. And what is the speciality of this particular membrane? This membrane can pump, or it is able to pump ions and other substances into the vacuole against the concentration gradient. So because of the ability of this tonoplast, what happens is the concentration of ions will be more inside the vacuole than in the cytoplasm, because the ions present in the cytoplasm will get pumped towards the vacuole. Functions: provides rigidity and turgidity, stiffness and support to the plant cells. And in animals also, I said vacuoles are there. One typical example is contractile vacuole present in amoeba, paramecium. In all these organisms, certain specialized vacuoles, food vacuoles are there, and contractile vacuoles are also present. Contractile vacuoles will help in excretion. Food vacuoles help in the engulfment of food particles in protist, like amoeba, paramecium. In all these organisms, food vacuoles are present. So the difference between food vacuoles and contractile vacuoles is that contractile vacuoles are meant for excretion. So excretory substances are stored in them, and it will later move towards the membrane, and from there it will be ejected out. Whereas food vacuoles are meant for engulfing the food particle. You have already learned how amoeba is capturing the food. When it encounters any food particle with the help of the flexibility of the plasma membrane, or you know that pseudopodia will be formed. So pseudopodia is the organism is able to form pseudopodia. It is because the plasma membrane is flexible, and they'll form, or they'll put forth pseudopodia and engulf it, or these pseudopodia will be encircling that food particle, and finally they will form a vacuole, which you call as food vacuole. And inside the food vacuole, with the help of the enzymes, it will get digested and the nutrients will be absorbed. So you had be learning it from lower classes. Once again, the different functions of vacuole, they'll provide rigidity and turgidity to the plant cells. And in case of animal cells, so that point also you should say, apart from providing rigidity and turgidity, it helps in storage. So different substances will get stored within the vacuoles, useful as well as excretory substances. And in animals, contractile vacuoles are present, which will help in excretion. And there are food vacuoles, which will help in engulfing food particle. Okay, can I change? Okay, no? Okay. Now we are going to learn about the next organelle. So what comes under endomembrane system, we have completed. Now we are moving on to the next organelle, that is mitochondria. Before we proceed to this particular organelle, just summarize what we learned about vacuoles and lysosomes. Nimida, what did we learn about lysosomes?
Their waste disposal.
Help in waste disposal. Then?
And then they are called suicide bags as well.
Why? Why you call them as suicide bags? When there is a disturbance in?
Membrane. Metabolism. It bursts.
No. And releases? How it can perform these functions, whether it is waste disposal or acting as suicide bags, how is this possible? With the help of what? What do they have inside?
Hydrolytic
enzymes are present. They'll help in breaking down these different substances. Then what did we learn about vacuoles? Alina Varghese? What did we learn about vacuoles? Just a minute. See, all those whose videos are off, I should understand that connectivity issues are there. Some are joining once in a blue moon. And please allow me to see your faces, children. I am noticing those who are regularly missing the classes. And one day, your parents will receive a call. And that can be a surprise for you. So please be regular in the classes. I'm regularly noting it. How many of you are repeatedly missing the classes? So please don't make it a habit. Okay, Alina.
I'm single. It is bound by.
A single membrane. What do you call it, Alina? What do you call the single membrane?
Tonoplast.
Sahan, tell me about tonoplast. Okay, Meherin. Yes, Sahan. Got up from sleep just now. Your face is telling that. Am I right? Partially. Okay. What is special about tonoplast? Completely lost. I'll make someone else to say and you will be repeating after that. Yes. Analysts?
What is the ability to pump the ions and other materials?
Into
the central vacuum.
So because of that? Because of that, there'll be more concentration of
In the cytoplasm.
More concentration of what?
Than that in the
more concentration of dash. Ions. Ions okay. Where?
Ions in the
Tonoplast is pumping it. So more will be there within than?
That in the cytoplasm.
Cytoplasm. Zahan can repeat now. You want to wash your face and join back? Basma, give me the functions of vacuoles.
provides rigidity and turgidity in
rigidity and turgidity. Then then finished.
No ma'am, wait,
let me next function. Next function. Who can help her? Contractile vacuoles. Where is contractile vacuole present?
Contractile vacuoles present in amoeba.
What function it performs?
Excretion.
It helps in excretion. And Rose, next point.
Provide rigidity and turgidity to the plants.
That she said. Last point. One more type of vacuole we discussed, no? Other than contractile vacuole. A type of vacuole present in protist.
Food vacuole.
What is its function?
Help in engulfment of food.
Help in engulfing food particles. Children, what I noticed is that you're not concentrating, you're not taking down the notes. Everything towards the end, if you keep for learning, then you will land up in trouble. I've told earlier also, unless you learn your daily lessons and attend classes regularly, take down the notes, you are going to have a tough time. So many chapters and 11th standard biology syllabus is so vast. I told you earlier also, in 12th standard, you don't have to learn these many topics. So here, plant physiology, animal physiology, everything is included. Cytology, so many topics are there, and the topic is these. Syllabus as such is very vast. But if you are not learning your daily lessons, you will find it very difficult. But it will be easy for those who are regularly learning. Some of you are even attempting for entrance also, no? So it is very important that you read the textbook thoroughly and attend the classes regularly. At least some points in the class itself you can learn. That is why I keep on repeating things. I know that in class 11, these many times of repetitions are not required. Like in 8th standard or 7th standard, I'm repeating those many times. But still, if you're not getting the benefit out of it, then I don't think I have to repeat the points these many times. I'll reduce the time I'm taking for explanation. I'm doing it thinking that you will get some benefit out of it. But if I repeat 5-6 times also, if you're not listening, so please be careful. Why I'm saying this is, it will be difficult for you. Towards the end, so many chapters, you know, 22 chapters are there. Even though CBSE has deleted some, so many topics we need to cover, everything you will get confused. So please make it a habit to learn your lessons regularly. Next, we are going to learn about mitochondria. Mitochondria is plural. Mitochondrion, O-N, that is singular, mitochondria. You know, these are very, very important organelles of the cell. Because it is here that the energy is being released. To carry out all the activities of the cell, energy is required. And these the energy required for all these activities will be released from the mitochondria. Or mitochondria are the sites of energy release. And in what form they release and store energy?
ATP.
ATP is known as the energy currency of the cell. It is because you know that we spend currency when we need something, or when you have to buy something, or to satisfy your needs, you will spend the currency and get the things done. Same way, ATP is the energy currency. So when there are some energy requirements, the ATP currency will be spent and the energy will be released to carry out the activities of the cell. So here you can see the picture of mitochondria. Mitochondria also you had learned in class 9. These are sausage shaped. I hope you all are familiar with sausages. You know, no? Something which is made out of processed meat. You all might have eaten. So it resembles sausage. Sausage shaped or cylindrical cell organelles visible only with specific staining under the microscope. So only if you stain it properly, these organelles can be seen clearly under the microscope. And coming to the shape, they look like sausages, or you can say these are some cylindrical structures. Their diameter is between 0.2 to 1 millimeter. Average sizes or average diameter is 0.5 mm and length is 1 to 4.1 mm. Okay. Their number, shape and size per cell are variable depending upon the physiological activity. So the cells, you know that these are very crucial organelles and these are present within the cell. But depending upon the physiological activity of the cell, all cells may not require plenty of mitochondria. See, some cells will be very active. More energy need to be released in those cells. For example, muscle cells. So in such cases where more energy requirements are there, accordingly, the size, number, and shape of the mitochondria too can vary. Number, shape, and size per cell that can differ depending upon the cell. Depending upon the physiological activity of the cell, there can be more number of mitochondria, less number, they can be bigger in size, smaller in size. So all that depends upon the cell. The physiological activity of the cell. So we cannot generalize and say that this is the number and size of mitochondria present in cells. So depending upon how active these cells are, how much is the energy requirement in these cells, the number, size, shape and number, shape and size of mitochondria can differ. These are double membrane bound structures. When we learned about...
Ma'am, can you show the previous slide?
When we learned about mitochondria, sorry, vacuoles, I told you that these are bound by a single membrane. But mitochondria are bound by double membrane, or they are covered by two layers of membrane. When you complete... Finished. Double membrane bound structures with an inner membrane and an outer membrane. So they are having two membranes, one inner membrane and one outer membrane. These membranes divide the lumen of mitochondria into two compartments. See, here you can see the picture of mitochondria, which is covered by two membranes, and you can see the inner membrane. This is the outer membrane, already marked outer membrane, and this is the inner membrane. Inner, and this is outer. An inner membrane is forming several folds. Do you remember the name of these foldings? These foldings are known as cristae. It has got an outer membrane and an inner membrane. An inner membrane forms several foldings. Why these foldings or cristae are essential? Any guesses? Why it is necessary? Why these foldings are needed? Will it benefit the mitochondria in any way? Think about villi present in small intestine. There also you can see so many finger-shaped projections. Yes. Here, these cristae will help in increasing the surface area. But for what? For energy-releasing reactions. So when it comes to small intestine, that was for increasing the surface area for digestion and absorption of nutrients. But here it is meant for increasing the surface area for energy-releasing reactions or energy releasing activities. These are the powerhouses of the cell. These organelles you call as the powerhouses of the cell. You know what is happening in a powerhouse? Electricity is being generated, energy is being released. So these are the powerhouses of the cell, because it is in these organelles that energy is being released, and that too in the form of ATP molecules. And as and when the cell needs energy, the ATP molecules will break down and releases energy. And the structure, they have got a double membrane, an inner and an outer membrane. Inner membrane forms several foldings, and these foldings are known as cristae. It will help in increasing the surface area for energy releasing activities. And then here it is mentioned, these membranes will divide mitochondria into two compartments. This is the first compartment, one compartment, and the other compartment. Understood? So it is dividing the organelle, the space within, into, or the lumen means the cavity or the space. Lumen, cavity or space within the mitochondria, into two compartments. Okay, and here I have marked those two compartments, how it is dividing it into two different cavities, the outer compartment and the inner compartment. So this is one compartment. This is one compartment and this is the other compartment. Once again, these are bound by two membranes, inner membrane and outer membrane. And these membranes will divide the lumen or cavity or the space of the mitochondria into two compartments, the outer compartment and the inner compartment. Outer membrane, that is the boundary, not about the compartment, the outer membrane. I told you it is having two membranes, outer and inner. Outer membrane is the boundary. It is the outermost layer. They form the boundary of the organelle. Inner membrane will form infoldings or different foldings. These are folded inwards, and you call it as cristae, which will help in increasing the surface area for the inner membrane. And this extra surface area or extra space is needed for energy releasing reactions. And both membranes are provided with specific enzymes. So within these membranes, different enzymes, specific enzymes are present, and they increase in number, or these organelles divide and increase in number by means of fission. So they split and they will form two new mitochondria. Once again, it has got outer and inner membranes. So once again, from the beginning, these are sausage-shaped cylindrical structures. Sausage-shaped cylindrical structures, and they are having two membranes covering it, inner membrane and outer membrane. These membranes will divide the lumen or cavity of mitochondria into two compartments, inner compartment and outer compartment. And inner membrane is thrown into different foldings, and these foldings are known as cristae. And these cristae will help in increasing the surface area for energy releasing reactions. And outer membrane forms the boundary of the organelle. And in both these membranes, the specific enzymes are present, and they divide by means of fission. Coming to the functions. I will show it again. Mitochondria, these are the powerhouses of the cell, and you know the reason. They produce energy. Cellular energy means energy required for the activities of the cell in the form of ATP. And these are the sites of aerobic respiration. Children, in class 10, you had learned the differences between aerobic and anaerobic respiration. And cytoplasm is the site for the first step, glycolysis. Breaking down of, do you remember all that? Glucose is broken down, or the glycolytic pathway or glycolysis is taking place within the, cytoplasm. Glucose is broken down to pyruvate within the cytoplasm, that is common for aerobic and anaerobic respirations. But when it comes to the next stage in aerobic respiration, it will be taking place in the mitochondria. Mitochondria are the sites of aerobic respiration. And you know, respiration is a source for, or it is carried out what for, children? Why do we respire? Why do we respire, children? What is the main reason why we are respiring? By means of respiration, what is released? When you respire, carbon dioxide. Forgetting carbon dioxide only. See, just by taking food, you are taking sufficient food or 3 or 4 times meals a day. But if this food is not, or these food is not getting digested, and you know that it has to, once digested, what will happen? They'll reach each and every cell. The digested nutrients will be taken to each and every cell. And there, what happens to these digested nutrients? It will combine with oxygen, that is respiration. And energy will be released. That is how we get energy. So digestion and respiration are very closely associated. So by means of digestion, the food that we have ingested will break down into simpler particles. And these digested nutrients will be taken by blood to each and every cell. And when you inhale oxygen, oxygen is also supplied to each and every part, each and every cell. And there, the food will get, the glucose will get oxidized, and thereby energy will be released. So mitochondria are the sites of aerobic respiration, where respiration takes place and energy is released. Then matrix contains, matrix is the substance present within the mitochondria, just like cytoplasm. So within the mitochondria also, a matrix is present, and these contain, or this matrix contains DNA, RNA, ribosomes, 70S ribosomes, and other components needed for protein synthesis. Children, in class 9, again I am speaking about what you had learned in class 9, two organelles are considered as strange organelles. You had learned it. Can you tell me which are those two strange organelles? Anybody? Two cell organelles, we call it as strange organelles. Nobody is remembering. Which are those two strange organelles? All are having amnesia, dementia. This is some point which you should never forget. All the points you may not be able to remember, but certain points will strike us, no, that you should not forget. These are strange organelles. Only two we had learned like that. And why we call them as a strange organelle? Shabari, which are those two strange organelles? One already you might have got a clue. Then the second one? Why they are known as strange organelles, can you say? Malavika? Yes.
Two membranes.
No. There are many.
They have different nucleus.
Different nucleus, or little more clarity needed. They have their own
nucleus.
Not nucleus. Something which is there inside the nucleus. They have their own ribosomes, and see, if ribosomes are there, protein synthesis will take place. But somebody should give the command for doing so. Who will give the command? Yes?
Genetic material.
Which material? Genetic material, yes. DNA. They have their own DNA and ribosomes. So usually where is DNA present? Where is the genetic material present? Within the nucleus. But these two organelles, within those organelles also genetic material is present. They have their own DNA and ribosomes. And what is the advantage of having their own DNA and ribosomes? They can synthesize their own proteins. That is why we call plastids and mitochondria strange organelles. So usually the genetic material, DNA or RNA, it will be present within the nucleus. But in these two organelles, DNA as well as ribosomes are present. Their own genetic material and ribosomes are present, and thereby they can synthesize their own proteins. And matrix contains single circular DNA, RNA, ribosomes. It is mentioned here, 70S ribosomes. I'll come to that. And components needed for protein synthesis, different enzymes, amino acids. those are the other components needed for protein synthesis. So with the help of that, they are capable of synthesizing food on their own. Sorry, synthesizing proteins on their own. Children, here you see the previous slide. Here you can find ribosomes. It is marked over here. And the red color coiled structure, DNA. They have shown it in red and yellow balls, ribosomes. So they are having their own DNA and ribosomes, and thereby they can synthesize their own proteins. And here, children, here it is mentioned 70S ribosome. And I told you earlier, 70S, 80S, different ribosomes are there. Usually 70S is found in prokaryotic cells and 80S is found in eukaryotic cells. Okay. But in mitochondria and plastids, the ribosomes present are of 70S. Once again, I will repeat, the ribosomes present in prokaryotic cell is 70S. And in eukaryotic cell, it will be 80S. That is, you can find them freely scattered and found attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. Those are of 80S. But those present in these strange organelles like plastids and what else we said? Mitochondria. They are of 70S. So that you should not get confused. 70S is usually found in prokaryotic cells. 80S in eukaryotic cells, but in chloroplast or in plastids and in mitochondria, the ribosomes present within are of 70S. Okay, somebody wanted to see the previous slide also. Who wanted to see this outer membrane, inner membrane forming different foldings? Annelies, was that Ansel? Ansel, che. Annelies, who wanted to see?
No, ma'am, it's me, Emily.
Okay. Which one? This slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Over?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So can we summarize what we learned about mitochondria, Zahan? Hope you're feeling better now. Yes. Tell me any point about mitochondria that we learned. Either the structure, functions, any point you can see.
It's the site for aerobic respiration.
These are the sites for aerobic respiration. Jyothi, next point.
It is a sausage-shaped or cylindrical.
These are sausage shaped or cylindrical.
Unless stained, it cannot be seen.
Okay. Next point. Elaine?
They have a diameter of.
Tell me some other important point other than the size, dimensions. You say another point. That you will be reading out, I know. Tell me some other point.
Their number, shape and size per cell are variable depending on the psychological attitude.
This will not work, okay? Here afterwards, when I ask something, don't read it. Nimita, another point?
They have double membrane.
Two double membrane or one double membrane. They are double membrane structures. Okay, inner membrane and outer membrane. Then Tushar?
Yes. Ma'am,
Any point?
These membrane divide the lumen of the mitochondria into two, which is outer membrane and inner membrane.
No, outer compartment. You're saying it is dividing it into two compartments, outer compartment and inner compartment. Why the inner membrane is provided with cristae? Basma? Why cristae are present? Yes, Basma.
Ma'am, I don't know.
Devi?
To provide surface area.
It just provides the surface area, or it will help in enhancing, improving, increasing the The surface area for what? Surface area of the membrane was given in the notes. But what did I tell you? It will help in increasing the surface area for what? What is happening there? What is happening there? In mitochondria, which is the main function, main thing happening? It will help in increasing the surface area for energy releasing reactions. Adulya, mark present. Thank you, children. See you next class.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.